connection between the digital and the physical world, and how one can give his audience a digital experience, making them question what is real and what is not real. So let's give him a really big round of applause.
Glad to be here again, third year already, and I'm nervous as always. And I want to invite you for today to come with me through a journey. I'm gonna show to you a bit of my progress of the past 6-7 years from the university time, like before NFTs. During the NFTs period, how I got into this industry, and to the present time, and to show you all my mixture between all the things I do. A bit of beer. First of all, my background is in traditional art. So I studied fine art in Cluj-Napoca at UAD. And later I got a scholarship to go in Madrid at Complutense University, where I elaborated and I profundated even more the study of fine art. And as you can see here, I don't know, of course, the quality maybe is not the best being so dense, but just to have an idea of my background, you can see here, those are paintings on paper. So this is the period before even knowing about NFTs and blockchain and stuff like that. This is like 2016, 17, something like that. I always had a touch of fashion into my work. Like, I used to customize like fashion items, like sneakers, caps, jackets, even some toys that you can see here painted and customized with some graphics. At the same period of time, I got a bit into the digital side of art when I exhibited and I produced and exhibited video mapping projections together with my paintings and my video mapping projections. They were exhibited in like Tokyo, Brussels, Paris, Barcelona, Cluj-Napoca, and some other places. So that was my period of trying to get into these like gallery artists. More into the like fine arts market, kind of. But later, after many trials, doing a lot of different things, as you can see, I have a variation of mediums that I work. For example, here, this is a video mapping projection, like 8 meters per 8 meters on a screen in a gallery, and this is a painting. So those are. It's so strong contrast between these kind of mediums. I just want to scroll a bit here. Of course, those are, it's interesting because those are shots from my Instagram, and was first time when I saw, so I screenshot my Instagram chapter by chapter, and I put everything together, and for me it was super interesting to see the whole picture of my work, you know? Even if I have, those are like 300 and something, I have maybe thousands of renders and pictures with my work. But, I'm sweating, like, I'm sorry, I don't know why. I think this off, sorry, one moment.
No problem.
It's okay.
I can not concentrate my sweating that hard. Ooh, okay, thank you. Yeah. Going forward, I want to jump into the NFT period and how I got into this. I first heard in 2018 from a friend. He asked me, hey, do you know, you are an artist, you are doing so many things. Have you ever heard about NFTs and all these new things that are like blowing up? And I said, no, let's see what that is. And after research and looking around on OpenSea and everywhere I could get some information, I was like, oh, this is super, I don't know, I felt something like there is an opportunity for me to go somehow to the next level and introduce this touch of like technology and new things into the art, you know. I was always trying not to follow the traditional thing, you know, and trying to always add something into my work. And that's how I made the first NFT collection, like it was my personal project called Primal. Here you can see some samples. Basically, it was a collection of PFPs, like traditional PFPs, and you could choose from 121 PFPs. There were not thousands and so. There were only 121. And some of them you could combine and then evolve. Like, for example, this one, it's an evolved one as a combination between, let's say, this and this. So if you would own in your wallet two NFTs, two primals like elementals, you could evolve into this one. It was not very clear, neither for me, neither for the people, what I was trying to do with this PSP collection. I was just trying to do something at that time. But my collectors, my previous collectors, because I sold like paintings and other works of art to collectors, they were kind of following me into this transition that I had to the NFT space. So they were my collectors, my initial collectors, people from Web2 or people that don't even have apps like Instagram, like old people, they were stepping with me into this new world, let's say. So it was very interesting for me, the capacity of bringing people with me into what I'm trying to do. And yeah, somehow being like an ambassador of NFTs. Everything changed. Once I launched the collection, like 2 months later, I got into this networking of designers that were working into newest projects in the market. And then a lot of collaboration started. Like people were asking, hey, do you want to jump into this project, design something for us? Hey, do you want to do something for us? Do you want to do something for us? Yeah, everyone was like asking me to do like one of ones in their collection. Like to look like, for example, this monkey, track monkey. It was a generated collection, like as a traditional collection, but they wanted the 101, so I made this for them. So all the traits were only on this monkey. Then other collaborations that came later. And here is where I started to develop my design skills. I got into all these new softwares, and it was like, I don't know, explosion of neurons in my head when I discovered that I really can manipulate 3D digital matter and build anything. I mean, now I know that I can build anything. At that point I didn't know, but I was like super intrigued about the 3D stuff and design. And slowly I just worked into this direction like a lot. And in here I had the first touches with the fashion, where I designed this concept of sneakers that you see here. Those are not functional shoes, they're only concepts. Then pushing more, creating toys, concepts of toys, concepts of fashion items like glasses, another concept of toy, auto. This you could mint it for free 1 year ago. I think it's still on OpenSea. Pushing forward into the fashion, like creative direction for some projects, more designs. Shoes, sunglasses, shoes again. I love shoes, by the way, in the fashion industry. but the good things in fashion, not the bad ones. Then more fashion, like bags, concept. This is a nice period of my work, like the beginning of AI tools that you can use to generate images. I was always, I had this conflict in my head, and not only in my head, also with people, some debates about using the AI and to position it yourself as an artist and saying, okay, I generate this and I'm an AI artist. I see it more like a tool of like sketching things and developing mood boards, you know, rather than going into Pinterest and, I don't know, looking for some style and getting a lot of things from Pinterest in 3 hours. I have my own bot on my computer, I talk to him and I customize what I want to see in 15 minutes, you know? So it's kind of a tool that I used in order to get concepts, like this one. You see those glasses? Basically, this is AI generated image, but here you don't see it because it's animated and here I cannot play it, but basically it's the 3D model of this. So this is how I use the AI into my work, right? Generating mood board, generating things, and then bringing them to functionality. First of all, functionality in theory on computer, then on real life. I will show you later what I think about. Another breath. Again, more AI, pushing more a bit with the car, automotives. I love cars, but they are too complex to design. More fashion items like bags. Big collaboration with Futures Factory, a project that I still collaborate with. Then the one of my favorite collaboration in the NFT industry, BitHouse, which are also like a Romanian blonde as me, so it was a pleasure to work with them. And of course, besides this collaboration, I had, as you say, like I worked with Artifact, a kid called Beast, Trapmonk in Futures Factory, Crypto Fooders. Okay, maybe those names doesn't tell anything to you, but they are like good projects. Hey, good to see you. Going forward a bit, I don't know how much time I have left. Okay. Again, more fashion. So you can see slowly adding more and more fashion items and fashion designs. Also some, I don't have that much on this collage, but I have a collection of furniture concepts. I only have this one, which is an installation that I imagine into a venue. But a lot of design mainly. Fashion and... look, this is the key of these concepts I made for them, the assembly toy. Going a bit... the beast, this is my beast. More shoes, more concepts. Sunglasses again, this helmet. Is there anyone from Zen Academy here? Okay, I think you own this. I made this for them. And they airdrop it for all their community, to all their community. Okay, more fashion, more sneakers, more shoes. And here in this period of my life, it's where I got into something super new for me, and the most interesting thing that I ever got in is the 3D printing industry. Working with some other projects and discovering this possibility and this, like, it's super optimized lately. It's nothing like 10 years ago where you could use a printer, but very like, doing too many things, spending a lot of time. Oh, what's this? This is a dislike button. Who put it? Who's there? I'm haunted or something like that. I was thinking about the 3D industry. And here is where I jump into Brook. So what you saw before, all those concepts like shoes, glasses, and everything 3D related, were like concepts, even if they were functional design. They were not into the real world, they were not brought into the real world. And here, some months ago, I printed my first sneaker. I don't have it here yet, but this one. Yeah, it's not really visible here, but basically this is a physical item. And I made this for Future Factory, which is gonna be the item they're gonna not airdrop, but as a collector of Future Factory, the Pioneer collection, you could claim it with like a, I don't know yet if a discount or for free, but like almost for free. So you this is how somehow the utility that Future Factory brought for their collectors. And I'm their designer somehow, partner designer. Like, those are the same shoes. It's here, it's me working. Here you can see a bit of my process. Basically, when I design anything, first of all, I work in Gravity Sketch, which is like a 3D modeling software, but in VR. So imagine that you have a cube here in front of your eyes when you put the glasses. And you can manipulate it in any shape. So you can, the shoe or anything that you see, it's a cube at the beginning. It's interesting for me as a designer to have a cube at the end and then few sessions later, like dozens of hours later, having the thing that I want to get. This is somehow how it looks when I'm in VR. So I see this object, let's see. And then later post-processing in different, I mean in Blender mainly, and other 3D modeling softwares, and then with other softwares to print, to prepare it for print. So it's like a mixture of things. And here is where I got a bit away from my traditional background, because my focus mainly is on these things that involve a lot, like tools, like computers, headsets, but those, that's the thing that I can relate on, like the paintings I made many years ago, it's what gave me the fuel to push it and then to explore new mediums, because how I see the world of art is not like positioning as a painter. I'm not a painter, I'm not a sculptor, I'm not a footwear designer, I'm not an NFT artist, not AI artist, nothing like that. I'm artist exploring anything I like to explore. I did even some songs with my friends, like lyrics, whatever. No, okay, I never took that in serious, but exploring is the way for me. Okay. And slowly we got into some VFX animations. I also like this thing to like to manipulate images, videos, pictures in order to place objects that doesn't exist. I don't have here an example because there is no possibility to play a video on this collage, but you know, if you know what a VFX is, like this one, see the beast, it's next to me there, but actually there is no beast there. And he's like just chilling, looking around like that, and I'm like speaking at the phone with my friends. This is like more, it's a more personal thing, like a personal project, just using my beast and having it as a companion, right? And we slowly got to the present time, where I developed even more the production of my work. And I left this picture at the end because it's important and it's related to this moment I want to do now. I didn't know, and I still don't know how to do this. But I want to speak about maybe something that you saw here on stage. Can anyone guess what's inside here? Like inside here, I mean. So easy, you broke my moment. Well, I'm joking. Of course, I expected that you would. Someone would say this. So this is my most recent project. It's something that I'm working on. And as you say, it's a design, yes, indeed. Sunglasses. Which and what's the link between this and NFTs? I see, actually, this is more a hybrid thing. It's not an NFT. I cannot call this, I mean, you cannot call this an NFT or anything. The painting is not the NFT. The NFT is something else, it's the contract behind it. So this is like that kind of hybrid, which basically it's a physical object that you can purchase, like in a traditional way, let's say like on any e-commerce website, right? Or you could mint it on a, I don't have yet a blockchain, I didn't plan yet where, but basically you can mint it, and later on you can verify your NFT on Discord and you can claim it. So this is like a blockchain edition of this design. And the box itself, can I come a bit closer, I step now. I don't know if you see, all of you, but basically I just want to speak before about the box, because basically the box of it, the case of it, is the certificate of authenticity. And it contains, if you see this is edition one, right? And under this one, you have a chip. You have a chip, so you could do this. It's a digital thing, yeah. So you can scan it with your phone. Here, it goes on my website, bojoreal.com, but at the end, this is a prototype, or it's the proof of concept. In theory, when you scan it, it will go on a personalized page of the sunglasses, and you can see all the information about them there, like production time, the materials, or any other information about them. And if they are blockchain edition, they would be linked, like, okay, this is 01 here, and the glasses themselves would have a 01 on them. But they won't have any value if they are separated. They have to be together, because this is the proof of this one. And from here, it could be only cool by wearing them. And I don't know, you can see, 360 view. And yeah, this is super early stage. I had this idea some like weeks ago, and I'm doing the first steps into developing this.
And it's 3D printed?
It's 3D printed, by the way, very good, thank you. It's 3D printed by me in my studio, and fully designed by me, printed by me, like, you know, the Snoop Dogg speech. And I think this is everything. Somehow, I don't know if I forgot anything, but what I wanted to show you here is like the journey I had and how I explored many, many things and how I synthesize everything I learned and I do what I like. Because basically, those, first of all, are made for me. I'm a sunglasses wearer. Time inspired, but sorry. And I made this for me, first of all. But then I say, okay, I think this could be something to explore more and launch, because some people ask me, I would love to have the glasses like you. And I say, okay, if you want, I can make something for you. And then another one, and another one. And then I say, okay, let's create something for everyone, so everyone can have it. This is being the first design, of course I'm gonna explore more silhouettes and shapes. But this is it for now.
And one Bitcoin.
And this is me. I don't know, but it would reach to one Bitcoin, why not? But I want to make it accessible for anyone, because I don't wanna